Rikki went out into the garden to see what was to be seen. It was a large garden, only half cultivated, with bushes big as summer houses of Marshall O'Neill roses, lime and orange trees, clumps of bamboo, and thickets of high grass.
This is splendid hunting ground,
Rikki said to himself, and his tail grew bottle brushy at the thought of it. It was Dazzy, the tailor bird, and his wife, on the beautiful nest they had made by stitching two big leaves together with fibers and filling the hollow with cotton and downy stuff.
What's the matter?
We are very miserable. One of our babies fell out of the nest yesterday, and Nag ate him.
That is very sad. But I'm a stranger here. Who is Nag?
Who is Nag? I am Nag.
It was a horrid, cold sound. An inch by inch out of the grass rose the head and spread hood of Nag, the big black cobra.
I am Nag.
The great god Brahm put his mark upon all our people when the first cobra spread his hood to keep the sun off Brahm. Look and be afraid.
Rikki was afraid for a minute, but then he remembered that all a mongoose's business in life is to fight and kill snakes. Nag knew that too. At the bottom of his cold heart, he was afraid.
Behind you! Nag's wife! Look behind you!
Wicked, wicked bird!
It's Nagaina, for she knew that a live mongoose in the garden meant death sooner or later for her family.